There is something very ironic about aircraft carriers. You see, their real task is power projection and execution of combat missions. But for the past 100 years, the biggest focus of naval aviation was on its most trivial part, the landing. The backward thing is that it's not the 6-hour combat mission over Iraq or Afghanistan that is the most dangerous. It's when you come back, tired, to land on a flight deck that is constantly moving up and down. In fact, since World War II, a whopping 50% of all naval aviation mishaps occurred during landings. The visual landing systems, such as the meatball, somewhat improved landing safety, but nowhere near enough. Arguably, the most frequent type of accident is a ramp strike, when an aircraft dips below the optimal 3-degree glide slope and hits the stern of the carrier. This type of accident is 3 times more common at nighttime than during the day. Without a doubt, landing on an aircraft carrier is by far the hardest and most dangerous thing that any pilot had to do. But not anymore, thanks to a software update which revolutionized naval aviation. Prior to the software update, pilots required total silence to have the mental focus to catch the arresting wire. That's why, in order to keep them safe, nobody but the landing signal officer would ever talk to the pilot during landing.
Center ball, hands off. There's a burble, hands off. Slight left, hands off.
But now, not only pilots can freely talk to anyone as they land on the carrier, but they can do so with both arms up in the air, without touching any of the controls. Now you might be thinking, this is some kind of automatic landing mode, similar to how drones land on a carrier. But it's not. The pilot is still controlling the aircraft. It's just that the software has changed how the airplane flies. But while landing an aircraft is considered an administrative task, how the landing software impacted the performance of new pilots, and what happens if the software malfunctions for a pilot who's not skilled at landing the aircraft manually, is not what you think. This video is sponsored by Conflict of Nations. Conflict of Nations is a free online PvP strategy game, where you can choose a real country and lead it through World War III. You can use anything from tanks and fighter jets to nuclear submarines to build your military and engage in battles against up to 128 other players. Your neighbors could be your enemy, or you could make alliances. The choice is yours. These are real-time, long-term strategy games that can take weeks to complete. This game is fully cross-platform, so you can play Conflict of Nations with the same account on both PC and mobile devices. And we bring you an exclusive gift. Click on the link in the description to get 13,000 gold and 1 month of premium subscription for free. This offer is only available for 30 days, so don't miss out. Landing on an aircraft carrier is like filling out paperwork. Just like any other administrative task, landing is something that naval aviators have to do in order to do what they really want to do. That said, for decades, landing on a carrier was considered the pinnacle of aviation skills, because traditionally, this is how it worked. When approaching the carrier, pilots focus on 3 things. Watching their lineup, so they can catch the 3rd or 4th arresting wire. The slope of descent, to make sure that the tailhook catches the arresting wire. And speed. Traditionally, pilots relied on the optical landing system, where the meatball would indicate the relative position of the aircraft with reference to glide slope. If the meatball was above the datum lights, the airplane was approaching too high. If the meatball was below the datum lights, the aircraft was too low. Finally, if the meatball was in line with the row of green lights, the airplane was on target. On a 4-wire arresting system, pilots would aim to catch the 3rd wire. And on a 3-wire arresting system, pilots would aim for the 2nd wire. As you can see, there's a lot of things going on here. In fact, during the final 18 seconds of the flight, pilots on average would make about 300 corrections on the stick and throttle. The reason for such a high number of corrections is that each time a pilot makes an adjustment, they must make counter-adjustments. For example, if they change the speed, it would affect the lateral position as well as the glide slope, which meant those would have to be adjusted as well. These tiny corrections are called flying on the ball, where everything is done manually. But here's the interesting part. The FA-18 is a fly-by-wire aircraft, which means the controls are digital and the aircraft automatically compensates when necessary. And if an aircraft can automatically compensate for a lot of things while in flight, why not use it during landing as well? In 2015, the US Navy started trialing a software update dubbed the Magic Carpet on the FA-18 Super Hornet and the EA-18G Growler. Note that the Magic Carpet equivalent for the F-35C is called Delta Flight Path Mode, or DFP. The idea was simple, to cut down the pilot's workload during landing on a carrier's flight deck, which would in turn make landings safer and easier. Magic Carpet achieves this goal by essentially automating the counter adjustments that were previously required to be handled by the pilot. Since the FA-18 is fully fly-by-wire, with control surfaces and throttles all commanded by a computer, the Magic Carpet software acts as the intermediary between the pilot and the aircraft. Additionally, the software accounts for and compensates for the effects of wind, as well as the movement of the aircraft carrier. As a result, the landings became significantly easier, safer, and repeatable. All pilots are now nailing the third wire every time. But before Magic Carpet was in use, naval aviators would compete over who could catch the third wire the most. Now it's the opposite. How many times does one miss the third wire, which implies how bad of a pilot they are? Remember those 300 minor corrections that pilots had to make as they approached to land? Well, with Magic Carpet, the number of adjustments can be reduced to single digits. That's a 97% reduction in a pilot's workload during landing. But how does Magic Carpet exactly work? The pilot manually inputs the speed of the aircraft carrier into the system, and then the Magic Carpet automatically computes the proper 3-degree glide slope for a safe landing. The system calculates the relative movement of the carrier's flight deck, so the aircraft knows exactly where the landing area is. Once the pilot gets on the meatball, the Magic Carpet locks in and maintains the proper trajectory and speed automatically. With regards to counter adjustments, Magic Carpet decouples roll from yaw from pitch, meaning that a single input does not affect the other variables, which means no more counter adjustments are needed. I should mention that Magic Carpet is what the original program was called. It has since been renamed to Precision Landing Mode, and it only works on FA-18s and EA-18s. But let's be honest, Magic Carpet sounds much cooler. But how do new pilots feel about using it? In 2021, something astonishing happened. The US Navy brought their newly winged pilots to aircraft carrier USS Gerald R. Ford to conduct their first landings at sea both during day and night. Landing on a carrier at night for the very first time used to be quite a nerve-wracking experience for any pilot. White knuckles, shaky hands, and tense facial expressions. During the Vietnam War, researchers actually hooked up a bunch of sensors to the aviators and sent them into combat while measuring respiration, heartbeat, sweat, and so on. Researchers found that getting shot at in combat was pretty stressful, but landing on the aircraft carrier at night was even more stressful since it pegged all the readings. But with Magic Carpet, this is no longer the case. Something that used to be incredibly difficult is now actually a little bit of fun. Back to our newly winged pilots on USS Ford, and the results were through the roof. The students demonstrated the best ever performance for day one of training. The pilots wished they could take credit for this performance, but it was the software that made everything so much easier. Test data showed the first-timers made about 20 corrections while flying on the ball with Magic Carpet, with that figure dropping below 10 once the pilots got used to the system. During one of the training days, out of 40 landing attempts, only a few had experienced Bolter. That's when the aircraft touches down on the flight deck, but the hook doesn't latch onto any arresting cable, forcing the pilot to fly off and attempt to land again. In addition, only a few of the new pilots had to make adjustments on their glide slope after being called out by the landing signal officers. Usually during qualifications, about 5% of new pilots would be disqualified due to their lane performance or boarding rate, which is the ratio of bolters to successful landings. But with the help of this new system, the disqualification rate may reach zero. In summary, during the 2021 USS Ford qualifications, the new pilots demonstrated remarkable success and a nearly flawless execution, thanks to magic carpet. It was also noted that these pilots experienced a clear reduction in stress and anxiety, and a boost in confidence, especially during nighttime operations. But what if magic carpet fails? Back in 2015, during early stages of development, the magic carpet software was pretty buggy and would sometimes disengage during landing. For this reason, during testing of the magic carpet, pilots were allowed to only do so many coupled landings with the help of the software, and the rest had to be done manually, just so that they would maintain their landing proficiency. But as the software evolved, new capabilities were added, which even accounted for various failure modes. What if an engine or flight control surface malfunctioned? What if navigation failed? What if the angle of attack probe failed or a throttle control broke? As it stands, Magic Carpet can handle all of the above and more. In fact, the software has significantly simplified the landing process for F/A-18s, even with only one engine working. The latest Magic Carpet software, the PLM version 40, is considered fully redundant, with the goal of making it the default mode of landing on aircraft carriers. During one test run of the Magic Carpet, out of 598 passes, there was only one bolter and zero hard landings. Whereas when landing aircraft manually, several bolters and a couple of really scary landings would not have been too unusual. The software is so good that during tests, pilots would literally land the aircraft with their hands up in the air, without touching any controls. The test results are impressive, to the extent that the leadership actually said that they want the system implemented sooner than later. Now, Magic Carpet is a flight control augmentation system. It's still the pilot who lands the aircraft, and they could make fatal mistakes. But when are we going to see a fully automatic landing technology? Brace yourself, because that technology has existed for over 60 years. As early as 1962, the Automatic Carrier Landing System, or ACLS, was installed on aircraft carriers. ACLS used a radar to guide and automatically land the aircraft. By the mid-1960s, over 5,000 successful automatic landings had been performed. That said, the ACLS was rarely used, since it worked successfully only 60 to 80% of the time, which meant it was actually safer to develop manual landing skills than rely on automation. Rumor has it that pilots who use automatic landing outside of adverse weather conditions received a Scared Kitten Award from the LSO. Currently, the Joint Precision Approach and Landing System, or JPALS, is intended to replace the obsolete ACLS. JPALS is an all-weather landing system that relies on relative GPS signals, which are collected by 5 sensors aboard the carrier and later sent to the aircraft through a one-way data link. This results in a precise 3-dimensional positioning of the aircraft with a resolution of 8 inches. This is the same system that's used to automatically land F-35Cs and MQ-25 drones. All this said, some seasoned naval aviators are concerned that if the new naval aviators only learn to land on aircraft carriers with the help of the magic carpet technology, US Navy pilots might eventually lose the skill set needed to manually land on the carrier. Some worry that unexpected electrical issues may jeopardize the operation of the magic carpet software, and that pilots wouldn't know how to land the airplane manually. Remember this accident that we showed earlier? The investigation eventually found out that the pilot had forgotten to turn on the magic carpet equivalent on the F-35C, the Delta Flight Path mode, even though he thought he had. As a result, he was flying the aircraft in manual mode, which resulted in a less ideal speed during the final approach. The reality is that for magic carpet to stop working means that the aircraft systems would be in such bad conditions that pilots would most likely not be able to land manually anyway. Overall, test pilots have provided overwhelmingly positive reviews of magic carpet. The only complaint was that the amount of inputs required are so few that it goes against all the years of training and experience that one would have when landing an aircraft manually, and some pilots find that uncomfortable. At the end of the day, magic carpet is a win for everyone. It's a win for the pilots, as it makes their job safer and less stressful by shifting their attention from perfecting their landing skills to putting more focus on other combat-related skills. It's also a win for the US Navy, since there's simply too much on the line for something to go wrong while landing a $55 million fighter jet. It's a win for the aircraft itself too, because it would experience less hard landings and less stress on the airframe, contributing to the lifespan of the aircraft. And finally, magic carpet is a win for the aircraft carriers, since less bolters means more efficient flight deck operations. Currently, magic carpet and J-PALS are both operational on all American supercarriers. Play Conflict of Nations absolutely free. This online PvP game lets you choose your own strategy to engage in epic battles and take over the world. Click the link in the description to get 13,000 gold and 1 month of premium subscription. This offer is only available for 30 days, so don't miss out.